Hello students, today let us see a problem from the topic predicate calculus in the subject discrete mathematics. Let me read the problem first. Use indirect method of proof to prove that for all x p of x or q of x implies for all x p of x or that x is x q of x. So what is the indirect method of proof? Suppose we are having n premises h1, h2, etc., hn. That should conclude a conclusion C. So instead of proving that, we shall enough to prove, what we do is we just take the n premises given h1, h2, etc., hn. Along with this n given premises, we are going to take negation of the conclusion as an additional premise. When we combine these n plus 1 premises logically, we should get a false, that is a contradiction statement. So this is what we are supposed to prove. When we apply this indirect method of proof, what I going to do, it is enough to prove that just we take the given premise as it is, for all x p of x or q of x is the given premise. Along with this, I am going to take the negation of the conclusion. Negation of the conclusion. Conclusion is for all x p of x or that x is x q of x. This is the conclusion, negation of this conclusion. When we combine these two premises, we should get a false statement, contradiction we should get. Now, how to proceed? Let me split the solution into four columns: step, statement, formula, rule, justification. In the first step, let me introduce any one of the premise. So let me introduce this premise, negation of for all x p of x or that x is x q of x. So first of all, we have to remove the quantifier. Before removing the quantifier, we have to bring this negation inside the bracket. So in one of the video predicate calculus rules, I have told you, when we bring this negation inside the quantifier, that will change the quantifier. For all x will become that x is x, that x is x will become for all x. The same thing will happen here. For all x will become that x is x will become for all x. And additionally, the R connective will become AND connective. So that x is x, negation p of x, and for all x, negation q of x will get using rule T. When we apply De Morgan's law in step 1. This De Morgan's law is only meant for the connective. P or Q is negation P and negation Q. And the quantifier changing is already given in the predicate calculus rules. Now, this is a conjuncted statement. So let me separate these two statement formulas before removing the quantifier. So let me split up this that x is x, negation p of x, for all x, negation q of x, using rule simplification. Now let us remove the quantifier. So we are going to remove quantifiers. For removing, already I told you, we shall apply rule US or rule ES. For when we are having that x is x quantifier, we shall remove it using English alphabet. When we are having for all x quantifier, we shall remove it using Greek letters. This is our customary way. So let us use this one. So for that x is x quantifier, let me remove it using English alphabet. For all x quantifier, let me remove it using Greek alphabet. So English alphabet, Greek alphabet are used using rule ES and rule US for step 3 and step 4. Now let me introduce any premise that involves p or q, and this is the premise that involves p or q. For all x, p of x or q of x, let me introduce. This is by done using rule P, that needs no justification. Now from this, let me remove the quantifier. So again, I am going to remove the quantifier. So removing quantifier can be done using rule US or rule ES. Here we are having for all x quantifier, so let me remove it using rule us. So I am going to use Greek letter. Now let me combine step 5 and step 8. We are having R connective. When we are having R connective, we shall apply disjunctive syllogism. So what is the disjunctive syllogism? When two statements are connected using R connective, and negation of one of the statement formula is that when these two are combined, we will get the other statement formula. So when we are having negation of P of alpha and combine it using disjunctive syllogism, we will get the other statement formula Q. But one thing I told you already, when we combine a statement formula with English alphabet and Greek alphabet, the English alphabet will come as F in the final derivation. So A is there, alpha is there. When we combine these two, we will get the English alphabet alpha. English alphabet A in the derivation. So this is the derived formula when we combine step 5 and step 8 using disjunctive syllogism. And step 6 and step 9 I am going to combine using conjunction, negation Q of alpha and Q of A. Negation Q and Q is false using complement law. So this is what we are supposed to prove. We should get a contradiction false value as a final conclusion. So we got it. So with this the problem is over, and let us see another problem in the next video.